the southern cliffs of Africa, Cape fur seals bring defenseless young into the world. A challenging world, where a pup's journey to adulthood is under constant threat. A dangerous voyage of a seal led astray by one of nature's most mysterious migrations. Followed by hundreds of hunters, hungry for one of the ocean's most awesome events. The Feast of Predators. Winter on the untamed shores of the wild coast. Here, the calm ocean surface conceals the turmoil stirring in the currents below. Millions upon millions of tiny fish swimming for their lives. A formidable migration called the sardine run. A 10-year-old bull seal plunders the shoals. But he's not alone. He is a rogue in the midst of an army of predators. This is their annual feast. A feeding frenzy of immense proportions. The attack is relentless, and now the sharks join in. Birds plunder from the air. Eventually, the feast comes to an end. For the bull seal, this was a royal banquet. He watches the rest of the sardines swim away. It's now the end of winter, and the shoals disappear into the ocean depths. Their destination? One of the most puzzling, unsolved mysteries of nature. With nothing left to hunt, the predators leave the wild coast. The bull is 1,000 kilometers from home, and so are the gannets. They begin their return trip to their summer breeding colonies in the Cape. Not many seals ever embark on such a long journey. His return home will be a 3-month-long test of endurance. The predators follow Africa's southern shoreline from the subtropical wild coast all the way to the continent's most southern extremity, the Cape. Here, the coast is cooled by the currents and warmed by the African sun, an ideal habitat for birds and mammals that breed on land and feed on the bounty of the sea. The bull's home colony occupies a rocky island off the southern tip of Africa. 500 meters from its shores, he enters the kelp forest. It's November, the beginning of summer, and he joins other bulls returning to mate. But to reach land, they must run a dangerous gauntlet. The half-kilometer-wide corridor between kelp forest and the island harbors the most lethal of seal hunters, the great white shark, a calculating predator who's perfected the skills of surprise, ambush, and attack. To get past the enemy, the seals gather in groups and make a sprint for land. The combination of speed and porpoising maneuvers should confuse the attacker. Every run of the gauntlet could be a seal's last swim. Survival depends on the luck of the draw. This time, the big bull escapes the jaws of death and reaches the shallows. He's safely home. Now, he needs to stake out a territory. He has the advantage of being the largest bull around, and in a seal colony, size certainly matters. No one dares get in his way. Confidently, he returns to the same territory he held the year before. ...25 square meters occupied by 15 consorts. It's a tight and uncomfortable squeeze, and the bull needs to enforce the peace. He also won't allow any other males to invade his turf. Within a week, territories are defined and the pregnant females prepare to give birth. One of the bull's concubines goes into labor. The contractions come quickly. She's in pain, and the father of her pup takes no notice. She suffers through almost an hour of labor. The bull has no interest in her yet. His only concerns are the females in estrus. His first few breaths, and the newborn commands his mother's attention. Seven kilograms, and larger than most newborns. The perfect recipe for a seal that might attempt a journey such as the sardine run. But for the moment, his world centers on his mother. Their individual call, smell, and touch develop the imprinting that will bond them for the next 9 months. While mom rests, he finds his source of milk and figures out how it all works. Now, Now that he's dealt with the priorities of a newborn, he can take a good look around. He's not the only newborn on the island. Within a month, all the pregnant females of the colony give birth to ensure that they will all mate again before the bulls leave. The scavengers keep the island clean. The beginning of summer is a busy time of year on the Cape's rocky islands. It's the seabirds' breeding season, too. They pair off, mate, and tend to their eggs. At the gannet colony, mornings are particularly frantic. One of each of the chicks' parents fights through a barrage of beaks to get to the runway. Their fast-growing hatchlings demand a fresh catch every day. Gull parents have it easier. They pick up whatever the tide washes onto the beach, although they're not too keen on sharing. Cormorants prefer to nest higher up on the rocks. The catch of the day is liquidized and regurgitated on demand. It's a young bird's treat. While the birds feed daily throughout their breeding season, the bulls and mothers go without food through theirs. Oblivious to his mother's fasting, the young pup is quite a handful. He has an adventurous nature. But his mother doesn't let him go far. He protests. A week into the pup's life, and his father ambles towards him for the first time. 300 kilograms of pure strength, an icon for the pup to aspire to. But the bull doesn't even cast the pup a glance. His attention is focused on the pup's mother, now ripe for mating. Driven by instinct, she follows the bull and leaves her pup on his own. So small and vulnerable, yet already abandoned. But she must make the most of the bull's attention and mate before he leaves the island. This is probably the last time the pup will ever see him. The life of a newborn seal is no easy ride. By the end of December, the bull has fulfilled his only paternal duty, impregnating the females with his strong genes. For the next year, he will roam the ocean south of Africa, and perhaps he will follow the sardine run once more. Most of the adult females of the colony are now pregnant and need to feed. After 2 weeks of fasting, their fat reserves are depleted, and the pup's only source of nourishment, his mother's milk, is running low. Following her is not an option. And if she doesn't return within the next 5 days, he will die of starvation. Abandoned first by his father and now by his mother, life is not looking good for the pup. His mother joins other females on an expedition to find food. But before they can hunt, they must run the gauntlet. Once again, the cunning stealth of the great white shark is measured against the lightning reflexes of the seals. This time, the seals win. They spot the shark before it can make a move. Now the mother and her allies can look for food. They swim towards the mainland. 15 kilometers from the island, she finds a pocket of sardines trapped in the shallows. With agile moves, she picks them out one by one. On average, she would eat about 4 kilograms of these tiny fish, but this time, she needs to stock up her reserves and produce enough milk to stay on land with her pup for at least a week. This small school of sardines is just enough for a filling meal. Sardines thrive in these cool waters. Their habitat spreads over a 400 square kilometer underwater plateau that stretches south from Africa's shores. The ocean here is crammed with their favorite food, microscopic plankton, making conditions so perfect that these waters support billions of sardines, some of the largest breeding stocks in the world. And the secret to their success? Flood the waters with an oversupply of eggs, a vast majority of which do not hatch. But those that do develop quickly, and within 4 days, they hatch into larvae. They're plankton size now, bottom of the food chain, and even eaten by their own kind. Over 4 months, they transform into fish-shaped juveniles that can swim and shoal. 4-centimeter-long fingerlings, no better off in the food chain than when they hatched. And even when they reach adult size, they'll still be pursued by larger predators. But to catch a sardine, the predator has to be as agile as the fish. Mammals that hunt in water require custom-built features to capture their prey. Seals can remain underwater for over 10 minutes by slowing their heart rate and storing oxygen in their blood rather than in their lungs. Their nostrils are naturally closed when relaxed and compressed even tighter by the water pressure. While catching food, no water is swallowed either, because throat muscles close the gullet. While the seal mother gorges on the sardines and rebuilds her fat reserves, back at the colony on Seal Island, her adventurous young pup has found a playmate. The two make a mischievous pair, innocent of the fact that the gull has a lethal beak that could inflict a serious injury. The bird is quickly forgotten, and the two playmates romp and fight, already training for adulthood. By midday, most adults laze in the sun, or skypoint, a comfortable pose for a seal. And if adults do it, lying down seems a much easier option. 2 days alone, and the pup has played with his newfound friend and explored his surroundings. It doesn't seem too bad without Mom. By the third day, he starts to get hungry and explores the shore in search of something to eat. But kelp is no mother's milk. Maybe being home alone is actually not that much fun. So many females. Surely one of them could be mom? But not one of them smells right. And now he's desperately hungry. His calls for mom go unheard. Then he finds a source of milk from a female suckling her pup, and he tries to sneak in for a drink. But he's caught out. Mothers don't tolerate strange pups. This adventure is becoming dangerous. Then he wanders too close to another hostile mother. Killed. Will he survive till his mother's return? More importantly, will his mother return? The fifth day starts with all the promises of summer and the safe return of the mother to Seal Island. But she has no way of knowing if her pup has survived. The shore looks like a killing field. She calls and waits for a reply. And then, a familiar cry. Mom is home, and her young pup passed his first survival challenge. Now, he doesn't let her out of his sight. With each mouthful of rich milk, he builds his strength. But a healthy body is not enough to survive to adulthood. He will need to become shrewd and agile to keep out of trouble and find his own food, all talents that he still has to develop. Then, 6 weeks into his existence, one of these life skills is put to the test. For his first swimming lesson, his mother chooses a particularly rough surf day